communicating ideas with other people. And before I tell you my idea, I have just one idea I want to communicate with you today. Before I talk about it, which is an idea about pictorial space, it's about the way painters talk about and think about and explore space in their canvases. That's what I want to talk to you about. One idea. But before I do that, I am curious, I wanted you to share something with me, which is either a lot of places in someone's home where they can display art, a lot of different rooms, kitchen, living room. And I just was curious if you could share with me where you like, if you make a purchase, whether it's a reproduction or an original piece, where do you like to put it? Where do you like to see it? Where does it resonate with you? Jeannie, I know you've...
Yeah, I have art in every single room of my little teeny tiny 500 square foot apartment. I have it
really?
In my bathroom, I have it in my kitchen. Yes, I have art everywhere. However, I'm careful about the art that I put in spaces like bathrooms and kitchens because of the damage, because I'm all about preservation.
Good answer. To an artist, we like to hear that. So have you done a recent installation of a piece that you're really pleased with that you passed by and go, oh, I put that in the right place?
I have, actually, yes. And that's in my dining room area.
And what was it? May I ask, the reproduction, was it original art?
It's original art.
Anybody you would know or respond? Can you describe the work?
Well, I do my rooms by topic. So my dining room is all portraits and masks. My bedroom is all Japanese art. So I do, yeah.
You had the perfect answer. That was not a plan. Anybody else have a space they collect and display?
I have three floors, but I spend half my time in one room. So that's the place where I put the most prized art. Most of the art is prints, not originals, although I'm explored. And what I like about that room, it changes light throughout the day, so I like things that kind of depend on a different character. The art tends to be a little bit of a modern, not entirely natural looking, but mm-hmm. but also like kind of the poker type of thing too.
Mm-hmm.
And anything that speaks to being casual and connecting.
Oh, nice. So are there any names that people could pick up or respond to in terms of your reproductions? Anybody?
I like Paul Clay. I don't know if you've seen one. I actually had an exhibit a number of years ago next door here. And one of them had it as like a pyramid. He went to Egypt and he was mm-hmm. trying to capture a light. And it's like a very sophisticated graphic art, but done in the 30s.
Yeah.
And literally, the light changes on that during the course of the day. And for some reason, I don't know why I like pyramids, but maybe it's like my home's in West Virginia. It's just something you're drawn to.
Yes, yeah. That's perfect lead-in for what I want to talk about. How? So Hal mentioned an artist who has altered sort of a traditional look at space, and what I wanted to talk about was a little bit more contemporary look at space. So my teacher used to do this gesture in class. I studied with him for some time, so I respected him a lot, but he would do this thing which I never understood. He'd pick up a canvas, he'd walk around the studio, and he'd say, This is all it is. It's just a rectangle. And I scratch my head, and then a week later, he would do it again. He'd pick up somebody's work and say, "This is all it is. It's just a rectangle." He even sometimes put it on the floor, and he'd have us start to paint on the floor, and he'd take paint and throw it down, or have us take paint and throw it down. And that had an advantage of you were really at a distance from it. When you started to make it, you could see how it would come together as a unit. But it really took me a long time to understand what he was talking about. And I'd really like to communicate with you in the space of this short talk, which probably will be about 10 minutes. What it is that took me a couple years